Please subscribe my channel trending information videos. You know those little, real people never do shit like this, moments that take you right out of the movie or show you're watching. You never see more of these than when somebody walks into a bathroom. For example, 1. In RoboCop, Bob Morton and his best work friend apparently struck with the urge to take a good old-fashioned simultaneous piss, perhaps crossing the streams if they're feeling whimsical decide to loudly disparage their boss while they do it. Not only do they not check the stalls to see if their boss is maybe taking a deuce first, they totally ignore the other 4 employees in various states of waste release. Those guys know the boss is throwing out the morning glory himself in one of the stalls, and they quickly evacuate the bathroom as soon as talk turns libelous. Meaning, even if the boss didn't happen to be there at that moment, there are plenty of other people who could have ratted them out. 2. Quirky people apparently just hang out in their bathrooms at home. That's a good encapsulation of the fact that TV bathrooms are not just for pooping or crying, they're for eating, exercising, talking on the phone, boning, knitting, more eating, weed smoking, dancing, and tons of just the sweetest bonding. All in a tiny, filthy New York City apartment bathroom. It's the same deal in Girls, a show in which roommates bathe together and hang out while one of them is on the toilet. They also have group meetings in the bathroom. Slate did a deep dive into how much of that show's plot takes place in the girls' crap station. In other shows, characters sleep in bathrooms, eat wheels of cheese, have important meetings and debates, and basically do everything short of move their TV in there. Oh wait. 3. People bond by sitting together in a bathtub, fully clothed. The only reason you should ever be fully clothed in a bathtub with other people is if you've been murdered or you're training your Olympic bobsled team, yet for some reason it tends to happen in movies quite a bit. Characters love to sit fully clothed together in a bathtub and bond as they talk about their lives, hopes, dreams, and how they don't even own enough towels to get them dry now. But at least one of them had gotten undressed first. In Garden State, Natalie Portman and Zach Braff bond over Braff's mom dying while in a dry tub, aka the most uncomfortable seat in the building. The floor would be better than that, guys. In Paper Towns, the popular girl and the protagonist only become friends after a good fully clothed bathtub session. 4. In Giggly, Ben Affleck's character apparently needs to talk himself into sex by flexing and yelling into the mirror. Somehow, watching his angry, young body all swollen and red is the perfect motivator to get out there and engage in some turkey time with a lesbian Jennifer Lopez. His speech is full of inspiring quotes like, "Get the bull by the horn. You know what I'm talking about? I'll give you the horn. Want to see the horn?" 5. For example, the seminal cheerleading classic, Bring It On, has an entire, cutesy teeth brushing scene where the future Mary Jane Watson and her nubile lover clean their teeth side by side, spitting multiple times. Suddenly, lover boy finishes brushing, wipes his mouth, and leaves the bathroom as if they've completed the entirety of their nightly foreplay. Rinse. Rinse, you pig. Will Ferrell's character in Stranger Than Fiction is so meticulous about every step of his brushing process that he knows exactly how many times to brush each individual tooth. But we're supposed to believe he's totally cool just leaving all that sudsy shit in his mouth all day like a rabid old yeller who seconds from being shot to death by a child? The Devil Wears Prada manages to show Andy spitting out her toothpaste, which magically hasn't foamed in the slightest. 6. Nobody in movies tests the temperature of their shower. Showers are like the kids from Harry Potter, it takes a really long time for them to get hot. The first water out of the shower head is the several cold gallons that have been sitting in the pipes all night, before the good stuff from the hot water heater arrives. Most people will thus turn it on and take care of other business for half a minute before testing the temperature with a hand, then finally stepping into it. In Psycho, the Psycho remake, and the Scream Queen's homage, she stands there and lets a blast of ice-cold water blast her in the boobs. Hannah from Girls does the same thing in a scene that somehow features less Lena Dunham nudity than usual. Seinfeld does it in that episode with a whole B-plot about Kramer's apartment's water pressure. Showers are like the kids from Harry Potter, it takes a really long time for them to get hot. The first water out of the shower head is the several cold gallons that have been sitting in the pipes all night, before the good stuff from the hot water heater arrives. Most people will thus turn it on and take care of other business for half a minute before testing the temperature with a hand, then finally stepping into it. In Psycho, the Psycho remake, and the Scream Queen's homage, she stands there and lets a blast of ice-cold water blast her in the boobs. Hannah from Girls does the same thing in a scene that somehow features less Lena Dunham nudity than usual. Seinfeld does it in that episode with a whole B-plot about Kramer's apartment's water pressure.